Google just leaked Gemini 3 and developers are losing their minds over what they're seeing in the backend code. Screenshots are flooding developer forums showing references to Gemini Beta 3.0 Pro hidden inside AI Studio, and the performance numbers people are extracting are absolutely wild. The leak happened when Google started internal A/B testing last week. Developers noticed unusual activity in the model selector dropdown, and when they dug into the API responses, boom! There it was, Gemini 3 Pro and Gemini 3 Flash, both sitting there in the code commits. Google hasn't officially announced anything yet, but the evidence is everywhere. Reference strings, performance metrics, even new UI elements that weren't there before. Here's what makes this insane. The leaked benchmarks show Gemini 3 absolutely destroying Claude 4.5 Sonnet in coding tasks. One developer managed to trigger it to generate a perfect SVG rendering of a Nintendo Switch controller. Not just the basic shape, but every button, every curve, pixel-perfect accuracy. When the same prompt went to Claude, it struggled with proportions. GPT-4 couldn't even get the joystick positions right. But Gemini 3 nailed it first try. The coding capabilities are what's really shocking everyone, though. Early access testers who've managed to activate it through backdoor methods are reporting that it can build entire React applications from scratch. One person asked it to create a fully functional Spotify clone. 20 seconds later, they had a working app with authentication, playlists, search functionality, everything. The code was clean, properly commented, and used modern best practices. No spaghetti code, no deprecated methods, just production-ready output. But here's where it gets really interesting. Buried in the code references, developers found something called DeepThink Mode. This isn't just another fancy marketing term. It's a completely new reasoning architecture that lets Gemini 3 actually plan its responses before generating them. Think of it like giving the AI time to actually think through complex problems instead of just spitting out the first thing. That comes to mind. When DeepThink is activated, the model takes about 3 to 5 seconds longer to respond, but the quality jump is massive. It can solve multi-step math problems that would normally require breaking down into separate prompts. It can debug code by actually understanding the logic flow, not just pattern matching. And then there's Agent Mode. This is the feature that's got everyone speculating about Google's real endgame. Agent Mode lets Gemini 3 take control of your browser, actually control it, click buttons, fill out forms, navigate between pages. Imagine telling it to book you the cheapest flight to Tokyo next month, and it actually goes to multiple airline sites, compares prices, checks your calendar for conflicts, and books the best option. That's not science fiction anymore. The code shows it's already working internally at Google. The model comes in two variants from what we can see. Gemini 3 Pro is the heavyweight champion. It's designed for complex reasoning, long form. Content, deep analysis. This is the one that'll write your doctoral thesis or debug your entire code base. Then there's Gemini 3 Flash, which is built for speed, sub-second responses for most queries, perfect for real-time applications, chatbots, voice assistants. Google's clearly learned from the complaints about Gemini 2 being too slow for production use. What's fascinating is the infrastructure changes Google's making to support this. They've completely redesigned AI Studio with something called My Stuff, which sounds boring but is actually brilliant. It's a persistent workspace where all your interactions, generated images, code snippets, everything gets saved and organized automatically. You can return to any conversation from weeks ago and pick up exactly where you left off. The model remembers context across sessions. That's a game changer for developers working on long-term projects. The performance improvements are staggering too. Internal benchmarks that leaked show Gemini 3 Pro scoring 92% on HumanEval, which measures coding ability. For context, GPT-4 scores around 85%. Claude 3.5 Sonnet hits 88. This thing is approaching human developer level performance on standardized tests, on MMLU, which tests general knowledge across dozens of domains. It's hitting 94.6%. That's PhD level understanding across basically every academic field. But Google's not just winning on raw performance, they're winning on ecosystem integration. Gemini 3 is being built directly into Android 17. Every Android phone will have this model running locally for basic tasks, with seamless handoff to cloud for complex ones. It's integrated into Chrome, so it can help you browse, research, fill out forms, It's in Google Workspace, so it can manage your calendar. Write your emails, create presentations. Microsoft's trying the same thing with Copilot, but Google's infrastructure advantage is massive here. The rollout strategy that's emerged from the leaks is pure Google playbook. Enterprise customers get access first through Vertex AI. Probably within the next 2 weeks, based on the commit timestamps. Then developers get access through different pricing tiers. The free tier gets a stripped-down version, probably with rate limits. Paid tiers get full access to Pro and Flash variants. Consumer rollout looks like early 2025, starting with Pixel phones and gradually expanding to all Android devices. Here's the kicker, though. While everyone's focused on the model itself, Google's quietly building something much bigger. The leaked documentation mentions something called Gemini Workspace OS. This isn't just an AI assistant anymore. It's an entire operating system layer that sits on top of your regular OS and manages everything through natural language. Imagine never needing to click through menus again. Just tell your computer what you want, and it happens. The competitive dynamics this creates are fascinating. OpenAI just raised another $6 billion, but they're still fundamentally a model company. They need Microsoft's infrastructure to compete. Anthropic has amazing models but limited distribution. Meta's got distribution, but their models lag behind. Google has cutting-edge models, massive infrastructure, and distribution to billions of devices. If Gemini 3 delivers on what these leaks suggest, it's game over for the current AI race. What's even crazier is that this might not even be Google's biggest announcement this year. Rumors are swirling about Gemini Ultra 3, which is supposedly training on their new TPU V6 chips. If Gemini 3 Pro is beating everything else while being efficient enough to run partially on phones, imagine what the full Ultra model can do with unlimited compute. We're talking about models that could genuinely replace entire job categories, not just assist with them. The timeline is aggressive too. Based on the commit history, Google's been working on Gemini 3 since immediately after Gemini 2 launched. That's unusual. Normally, there's a longer development cycle between major versions. Either Google had some massive breakthrough that accelerated development, or they've been sandbagging, holding back capabilities to time the market perfectly. Given that OpenAI's GPT-5 is rumored for early 2025, this feels like strategic timing. Here's something that hasn't gotten enough attention. The leaked code shows Gemini 3 has native multimodal training, not just bolted on image. Understanding, like most models, it was trained from day one to understand images, video, audio, and text as interconnected modalities. That means when you show it a chart, it doesn't just describe what it sees. It understands the data relationships, can extrapolate trends, even spot errors in the visualization. Show it a codebase diagram, and it understands the actual code architecture, not just the visual elements. The implications for software development are staggering. We're not talking about AI that helps you code anymore. We're talking about AI that could replace entire development teams for certain types of projects. Need a basic CRUD app? Gemini 3 can build it in minutes. Need to refactor legacy code? It understands the business logic and can modernize it without breaking functionality. Need to debug a complex distributed system? It can trace through multiple services and identify race conditions that would take humans hours to find. But it's not just coding. The creative capabilities that have leaked are equally impressive. Gemini 3 can generate images that rival Midjourney V6, but integrated directly into your workflow. You're writing a document and mention you need a diagram. The AI generates it in line, perfectly matched to your content. You're creating a presentation and describe the slide you want. It creates the entire slide, animations included, formatted perfectly for your company template. The video understanding capabilities are next level too. Early testers report that you can feed it a 2-hour video and it'll give you perfect timestamps. For every topic discussed, generate summaries at multiple levels of detail. Even create clips of the most important moments. Content creators are going to go absolutely wild with this. Imagine uploading your 3-hour podcast and getting back perfectly edited shorts for TikTok, Twitter, and YouTube, each optimized for the platform's audience. What really stands out from these leaks, though, is Google's focus on safety and alignment. There's an entire subsystem called Constitutional AI Plus that seems to be Google's answer to Anthropic's Constitutional AI. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.